Hello friends, welcome to Aculmac Live. I am Kanchan Verma. Today we'll be discussing about a city, Liverpool, its culture and heritage. But before that, a word on our giveaway.
We have some unique Aculmac memorabilia which will make you look outstanding. The graphics on these corporate gifts are based on the global best business practices. To become recipient of one of these gifts for free, you have to watch this video till the end and provide your valuable comments, or you can also share your experiences. The person who makes the best comment would be chosen to become a recipient of this beautiful Aculmac gift, absolutely free, delivered to your doorsteps. The winner would also get a chance to be invited live as a distinguished panelist during our next video. What are you waiting for, friends? Please subscribe Aculmac and smash that like button. Now, let's get back to our discussion.
Hello friends, welcome to the show, and today we'll be discussing about one wonderful city, and that is Liverpool. To discuss about this wonderful city, we have Sitesh Srivastav, who has lived, traveled to Liverpool. And he's the best person to tell us about the history, the heritage, and the achievement of Liverpool in when we talk about the World Heritage. So welcome to the show, Sitesh. How are you doing today?
Hey, Kanchan, this is wonderful talking to you. And I, remembering Liverpool, I remember the great British city, Liverpool, today. And I want to share my experiences with you. How have you been?
I am wonderful, and I'm eager to hear about Liverpool. And I am planning to go there, maybe after when the good times come, after COVID. This is the first traveling. The Liverpool will be in the first list of my traveling.
Well, that's very interesting to know, Kanchan. I used to stay 26 miles, or 16 miles outside Liverpool, a place, a small, scanty, and sleeping town called Warrington. And I used to travel most of my weekends to Liverpool. And I have very fond memories of the city, fond memories of the remembering the historical presence of Liverpool in 1800s and later 1880, when the city got its first official tag of a city. But Liverpool was a bustling Atlantic shore place of the British mainland, and it is connected via the Mersey River and the Irish Sea. And it is a wonderful place to be, and I would like to discuss talk about certain places which have remained with me ever since.
That's great. And, the Liverpool was actually announced as a city by King John by 1207. And since then, this city is developing. So I would like to know, what is the history of this wonderful city?
Well, to start in the modern times, where it is located in the Irish Sea, connected with the Mersey River, in 1800s, early 1800s, this was the place which was known for the colonial slavery times of early British times. In fact, there is an international slavery museum also there. And that's where we had certain big traders' names who were on the slavery trade. It was also called the Atlantic slavery trade, where the Africans were put onto the ships and sent to the American mainland. Later on, this city became a big trade city, not just for the slavery, but also for bringing around traffic, trade, people, culture, food, and whatnot. And a lot of, literature, poetry, music, architecture of this city starts showing up after 1850. And I would like to talk about a couple of them, namely Albert Dock, Liverpool Cathedral, and the topmost and known all over the world is the Beatles Story Museum, about those four great musicians. And that's where I want to remember my journey with Liverpool all the time. And I maybe when you go, I will join you, Kanchan.
Sure, you are welcome, and I am looking forward for the good times to come. And you know, it became a port, and it remained a very, very progressive city till 1851. So I would like to know the place which you like most during your stay at Liverpool.
Well, Kanchan, I was mostly attracted for the, you know, out of all these places, the museums, especially the Beatles, because Beatle always has been very popular in India. Growing up in India in you know, late 70s and 80s, Beatles was a staple music in our homes, in our friends' places, and the parties, of course. So the Beatles Story Museum is something which is one of its kind of a museum in Liverpool. It tells the story of the four lads from the Liverpool who went on to become the most successful bands in the world from their small beginnings. And all over the Liverpool city, you can hear the hums and the twists and the foot tapping music of the Beatles in the taverns, in the restaurants, in the malls, in the sideways, in the street walks. This city is full of music, and Beatles were the ambassadors. Beatles had a great connection with India also, Kanchan. They had traveled to India in the 60s, 68, I believe, 1968, where they had all four or five of them had come to India. And so that is something, the Beatles Museum, Story Museum, I would like to go. In fact, I have, that is the only few of the songs of Beatles are the only English songs that I can sing very naturally. Other English songs, I am a connoisseur on those. Then comes the Albert Dock, Kanchan. It is one of the most aesthetically pleasing attractions. It is a World Heritage Site of that waterfront. And it is also a collection of several grade one listed buildings in the country. And most of the, you know, a number of Liverpool's popular attractions can be found in the Albert Dock. So, I mean, I have a very vivid memories of walking around Albert Dock and going to Beatles History Museum. I never mind, you know, paying around £4 of ticket by the from Warrington to Liverpool. And many Saturdays, many weekends, I have traveled and I have been to Liverpool. And I always was wondering, and when I heard about the Titanic's start point, the registry point was Liverpool, it adds to the aura of that city, right?
Yeah, it is a place of innovation, invention, as you know, and it is also a place or I can say a site of first airport, which was built in Britain. So I really feel that this city is quite vibrant, and I also feel that the ethnicity of the city is, I think, cosmopolitan, because every part of people from traveling from different countries you will find at Liverpool. So tell me any interesting incident about Liverpool.
Well, Kanchan, two things that stand out in my journey to the Liverpool. One is definitely the music, which starts with Beatles. The other is about the literature. The third is about the museums, especially the Maritime Museum, the Marine Museums. And I remember going to the Beatles Museum and watching everything in awe about seeing how four guys in the 15 years old, 16 year old guys, they went on to become the big musicians that we have known, the first star rock band. But you know what? The best part was finding out a very, very special souvenir that I want to show is the Beatles tie that I could get, which features all the four of them here. John Lennon, George Harrison, Ringo Starr, Paul McCartney, and their lives. And this is a prized possession of mine. And whenever I have put it on for a party, and it just takes me back to the Liverpool. And apart from that, Kanchan, I also want to share that in several of the Indian restaurants, I could hear the old stories of the connection between Indian ports and the Liverpool ports, because a lot of textile trade, indigo trade, spices trade during the British times were basically taken through the Liverpool port, Liverpool side. And I mean, I have wonderful memories of Warrington, wonderful memories of Liverpool. And the one that I also want to mention here, and we might cover someday, is Manchester.
Yes, so I would like to ask you any advice or anything which you want to tell our future visitors to Liverpool, how they should plan their trip to Liverpool.
Well, today's life, Kanchan, is mostly about the popular attractions. And I think one of the most popular attractions is the football. And Liverpool FC Football Club, Everton Football Club. That you can feel the football frenzy, the football frenzy in the air. And that is so stark different from the music world, which is so soothing music of the Beatles and the other musicians. So I think youngsters, youth, football fans, they should start with the Liverpool FC, the stadiums where they play. And then people should try to visit the historical past, and not 500 years old, but maybe 1,000 years old history is too far. But from 1800 years, the International Slavery Museum shows wealth, 18th century wealth that came from the British slavers transporting Africans across the Atlantic. And while you stand at the Albert Dock and look at the Atlantic Ocean, you just feel that somewhere in between there was one Titanic. But beyond that, there were the East Coast of America, which is not so far enough. But the icy waters of Atlantic, they are a real, real challenge.
Every city is attached with one story. If we think about Paris, then we also think about Paris the Prince. We also think about Helen of Troy. Likewise, if we think about Delhi, we think about Mughals, the attachment, the stories, the building, the architecture. And we think about Marathas and conquest. How you would summarize Liverpool in one sentence?
Charles Dickens, the great writer, Charles Dickens. I have read stories of Charles Dickens from my childhood days. And he has written some very, very interesting stories. David Copperfield comes to my mind right now. A Tale of Two Cities, Great Expectations. So for me, Liverpool, though it has a very vibrant, wonderful nightlife, for me, any day, Liverpool is going and is spending a peaceful walk around the Albert Dock, and idling around in the sun and just humming the music and reading Charles Dickens.
Now let's talk about the cuisine of Liverpool, and of course I also want your advice for the people who are vegetarian. So you have to tell us the vegetarian cuisine and non-vegetarian cuisine where people can go and pull their belly.
Well, Kanchan, it is interesting to note that the staple British food is fish and chips. So all over the Britain, you can find fish and chips as the go-to food. But in Liverpool, there is a very interesting fusion of food available. One, because of it has been a port city. So a lot of fusion of foods from Indian cuisine to the African cuisine to the British cuisine and Ireland, Irish cuisine. So and there's a big Chinatown also. So a lot of Chinese food. But again, Chinese food mixed with British flavors. So from a vegetarian point of view, there are some interesting Indian joints opens. Liverpool city center is a great place where you can get a nice and varied variety of foods. So food is actually, you can say it's a taste buds delight. It's very, very interesting. And some flavors are so well mixed. Sometimes you feel that you are not in Britain. You are in an international melting cuisine city.
Now, if somebody is planning a 15-day tour to Liverpool, so how would you like to advise how they should travel within the city, or they should take a tour guide, or they can travel by their own, taking a map and enjoy the sights and stories about Liverpool?
So there are, Kanchan, like any international hotspot, Liverpool has got a lot of opportunities for the city tour, city outskirt tour, hop on, hop off buses. There are limousines. One can do a 4-hour limousine or 5 hours limousine for I would not say less, but as much as $160 for 4-hour trip in the Liverpool city side. And that particular, it's a kind of a big car which can house almost like a 6 people in one shot. But, my favorite always has been by foot. I have always enjoyed by foot. I reach to the city and then I have taken by foot, because when you do the foot tapping on the road, you are actually getting the feel through the feet. And you are getting the sense of the town. And some cartographer had told me this. But I have also enjoyed the hop-on and hop-off bus. So for a £5 ticket or a £7 ticket a day, unlimited stops, unlimited rides. And one thing not to miss is the ferries on the Merseyside ferry, which takes to some of the very interesting attractions of Liverpool, from the old houses, colonial houses, Gothic structures, and also some of the very modern joints, food joints around the Merseyside ferry ride. So ferry ride is one. I would say hop on, hop off bus is one, but my favorite is by foot. By foot, Liverpool by foot.
Great. Now, I just want a piece of advice from you. Suppose if I am planning a trip to Liverpool, how many days should I plan for Liverpool? What will be the exact timing where I can stay there and have a satisfactory visit to this particular and beautiful city?
Well, if you are traveling to Britain, Liverpool is a must. Liverpool is a must. To get the feel, get the fragrance of the great English aristocracy. And I think 3 days, 4 nights is something that you can really enjoy by foot, by hop on, hop off bus, and by doing something very personal of visiting a special museum or trying to participate in some local event. So I think 3 days, 4 nights. But I have seen tourists coming from London and just staying for, you know, two nights and 3 days, or sometimes even, you know, 1 night and 2 days kind of thing. There are plenty number of buses and trains between London and Liverpool. Only between Warrington and Liverpool, there are 70 trains in a day. And the minimum ticket is £3.79 one way, and 16 miles takes just 20 minutes or so to reach from Warrington to Liverpool Lime Street station. That station itself is quite a Gothic and quite a interesting architecture it has. But I must say, if you are going there, and since I know you for some time now, you would enjoy a 3 days, a 3 nights, 4 days trip.
Now, let me ask you about the art and culture aspect of Liverpool, because I have read that in Liverpool, you will find mosque, you will find a cathedral, you will find a place for worship for African people. I don't know about any Hindu temple, but I would like to ask you, what is the art and culture or painting? What is the influence on those aspects of Liverpool art and architecture? It is more inclined to European art, or it's more inclined to African? So that I want to really understand.
So while, you know, I'm not an expert on the world architectures, but moving around Liverpool, I felt it had a great influence of the people or the traders who were touching its port. So one is the very Victorian style buildings in the British, Victorian style buildings. But then there are modern architectures as well. I even, you know, I visited one museum where they were showing that at one point of time when the slave trade was in big peak, they were also trying to build some structures which look more familiar to the people coming from other places of the world. So suddenly, once you reach there, whether you see Charles Dickens' house or you see the Cunard building, or the Albert Dock, there is something also, a triangle, Baltic Triangle. If you see that Baltic Triangle, that is something you will feel that this city has got a great balance of modern versus the medieval kind of architectures. It is sometimes it feels lonely in the city, but the night time, if you take a stroll around, let's say in the evening times, the kind of streets lit up with lights, lamps, and the music and the ambience, and then the breeze from the Atlantic, it makes for a perfect evening. Even single, it makes a perfect evening.
I have also read that Chinese were the very few settlers who settled at Liverpool very early, maybe in 18th century. And there's a very good intermingling of culture of Chinese and English or Irish. And we can find that kind of culture in Liverpool. So tell us about Chinatown, you just mentioned a few minutes before.
Yes, Kanchan, thanks that you asked about it. And I have seen Chinatowns across my travels. And suddenly, I have now realized that Chinatown is a very nice way of promoting any country's culture. In fact, we should have something like an India town across the world in all the countries. But talking about the Chinatown, you know, the it is in the Liverpool city center, and the gate of the Chinatown is basically brought from Shanghai when it was opened, and it dates back to the 19th century. And now it is the most visible. Chinese people are the most visible ethnic minority group in the city, and almost I don't know the numbers. And there are so many Chinese-owned supermarkets, restaurants, community groups spread across Liverpool's Chinatown. In fact, there is a Liverpool Chinese Gospel Church and the Liverpool Chinese Christian Disciples Church. And the arch located at the gateway of Chinatown, it is also one of the largest of its kind outside China. One full day, if you just look in the take into the hop on hop off bus, I think it takes you to the West Tower, the Beetham Tower, the Unity Residential, New Hall Place, Metropolitan House, the Plaza, Silk House Court. So and the commercial district of Liverpool. And I am sure that you will never for a moment be bored about this.
Well, after listening to you, I really feel like going to Liverpool. And I think when the travel will start, the first city I will be visiting, Liverpool. It was so wonderful to talk to you, Sitesh, today and know about the city where you lived, you have worked. So we'll be taking up any other city in our next episode. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you, Kanchan. Have a great day for bringing up the memories of Liverpool.
Bye, Sitesh.